Hello YouTube and welcome to another review, and this time we have Airfix's RAF Personnel. These are 172 scale figures. It does say series 1. I don't know why it says series 1. I haven't fathomed that bit out. This kit was made in 1972. It is of a good quality. It is a nice kit. There's about 37 figures you get, and about 47 pieces, as it says on the box. So set includes two items of assembly, and they are the accumulator trolley, which starts up engines, and you also have a team of two men carrying a rocket, and that's your basic assembly for this kit. The rest of them pretty much stand on their own. Now I have to confess, this set is missing two figures. I bought this set on eBay and I'm going to show you the two figures that I'm missing. I did take a shot from Plastic Soldier Review's image gallery on their sprue just to show you the two I'm missing. So if you don't hear from me for a while, I've been sued. So here we go, that should be appearing now. So I got this on eBay and it was literally stuffed with figures, and what had happened is the guy who had bought, I've bought Luftwaffe personnel and also RAF personnel, and the RAF personnel did come packed with figures, so there was actually nearly another box in the box that I bought, and unfortunately they didn't cover the two missing figures. They were also missing on the other sprues of the little freebie gave me, so that was unfortunate. So I do apologize straight away. I'll apologize for that now. That said, we shall take another look at the box on the reverse side. On the front door, you can see it's a very much a squadron scramble going on there, and the ground crew looking quite busy there, and there's a Hurricane just in the background there. So that's really good box art. This is the 1980 style box art, I believe, which I was very familiar as a kid, so it's quite nice to see again. Now they do, Airfix do still do the RAF personnel. I have seen some red box kits that they do produce, so look out for them. They are nice little kits, these, so they are still producing this kit, but I couldn't get my hands on that, so I went with the second hand one. So we'll flip the box over and have a look. So here we go with the box, and just as I remember it as a kid, we have the little images there of the people you're going to get inside the box, and there's our accumulator, and this thing starts up engines and stuff like that, so it's quite a handy piece of kit, very necessary. Here's a pilot, which obviously is included. This guy's holding up one of the cameras that would probably go in a fast aircraft, so he would fit that to the aircraft and take the film out, etc., check it for maintenance. And here's a guy holding up a Browning, which would go in either a Spitfire or a Hurricane, so that's quite good, and it's given you a little bit of a paint guide. Usual stuff on the back, if desired, figures can be painted, and it just gives you a guide there what you should be doing. And I think this is made in France by there. Humbrol are obviously owning Airfix at the minute, that's what that box states. And we do have 1986 written there on the box, so not too bad. So let's take a look at the contents. So this is just a quick look at the sprues, and then I'll go over them all individually. That's pretty much what you're going to get. I'll point out the positions of the missing crew members. So I've got one missing here, which would have been the WAF, Women's Auxiliary Air Force. And so she, I think she sat there, or she should have. And over here, in this section here, that would have been the officer. And like I say, unfortunately, they are not contained in the kit. That's just because I bought off eBay and there's two items missing, which I don't think the guy even knew. Oh, he probably did, who knows? But that's eBay for you. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. So that's pretty much the sprues. What I'll do is I'll now go over them on an individual basis and show you what they look like close up, and a little bit of a discussion on the way. So let's go and do that now. So it's chocks away with this chap. Obviously, lovely bit of motion going on there, and behind him he's dragging the chocks, which you would put behind. These ones are quite small, so obviously these are just for a fighter, and you'll just chock that to stop the plane from rolling when it's parking, and just in case, you never know, worst thing, the thing brakes are off and it rolls forward into the middle of the runway and causes an accident. So, and as well, a lot of the time you keep the brake on, get the engine running first, and then woof, off you go very quickly. So he's just pulling those either out the way or towards an aircraft. So very important figure. So this is our chap, Squadron Scramble, really good figure, rushing to his Hurricane or Spitfire, and really got a good piece of motion going on there. Very nice figure. Reverse is lovely. Look at that parachute there. Everything in order. Looks really, really good. Quite like this figure. Now I'm going to do him from the side just so you get a good... I mean, look at that. The motion is flowing through this guy. Here's our cyclist. And very important to have a bicycle on an RAF base or any other aircraft base for that matter in World War II, because the things are vast and you need to cover distance quickly. This one is a bit flashy, and you know, the bicycles, you probably see flying officers drive cycling on these to obviously maintenance crews, anything, just to get the job done quicker and to reach the objective very, very quickly. Very flashy, this one. It's got an injector pin mark just below the arm. I cannot guarantee all sets are like this, especially the newer ones. Who knows? The bicycle itself is pretty basic, but you're not going to expect anything truly amazing. Now this chap here, I'm just not so sure on the headgear, but apart from the headgear, it's absolutely brilliant. I love this one. He can only be passing this gun up because I think you can only fit the Brownings into the wing from the top, but it's a really lovely figure and I really enjoy looking at this one. Lovely sculpt, creases in the trousers, even the box has got detail on it that he's standing on. Really, really good. And the Browning's very, very good from this side. If I turn it round, it's a bit bland on the back, but here's what I'm on about regarding his hat. It's just a little bit of a flat squidge. So I don't know, I'd have thought it would be an ordinary standard flying cap, but it looks more like a peak cap, so I don't know on this one. Here's our chap filling the wing up with fuel, and he would be lying on top of the wing, I'd imagine, just putting the hose in to the fuel cap there. So again, quite good detail. You notice how the leg, his inside leg, just lifts off the base. I'd say that's quite tricky to achieve, and even his lower foot on the outer leg, you can just see the shadow there, so that's quite good. A little bit flashy on the hose, but that's to be expected. No flying cap, I think, on this chap, so he hasn't got his standard RAF cap. Flip him round, nice creasing in the overalls. But yeah, fairly good. Great little figure, this one. There's our flying officer. He's either just finished a flight and he's sort of nonchalantly just looking around and thinking, my God, he's got his hand in his pocket, and you can just see the jacket's just slightly turned upwards. So that's a great little figure. Quite like that one. Again, very, very good. There's the rear. He's just got a little bit of flash on his hat, but there you go, on his flying helmet. But there he is with his parachute pack. He's just slung it over his shoulder. Flying boots. It's a nice figure. And here's our chap waving the aircraft about the runway, and that's either for landing and as well as taking off. Again, you can see quite clearly his pockets and everything like that. Nice creasing on the trousers. That's a really good figure. Reverse, I may not dwell too much on the reverse of these figures. Obviously they're flight crew, they're not going to have much going on behind them, but it's a nice sculpt. Now here's our guy with the camera. Now this would have been used for photo reconnaissance. It was probably housed in a Mosquito, and it's quite a good representation of one as well. And he'll either be removing it for general maintenance or taking the film out, putting the film in and reinstalling it. Number of options with this chap. Reverse, doesn't give much away, but you know, it's a good solid figure. Now this chap's really good. You can see all the bullets on this ammunition belt. It is really quite a good figure. It's just everything about it. He's got nice creasing in his overalls, his flying cap looks great, his boot, there's detail on the boot. You may not be able to see that, I don't know, you should be able to, this is 4K we're shooting with. But that is a really good figure. So it looks like he could be sitting on the wing feeding the bullets in, or perhaps on the floor kneeling next to a gun case. Flip him round. Not bad, very good. So it's bombs away with this chap. I really doubt he'd be able to do anything like this in today's health and safety mad culture, but back in the day, this is probably how you handled a bomb. Whether or not he's taking one off, he's more than likely putting one on. So numerous bombers he could be actually installing that on. It is a small bomb. And even that would actually fit on a Hurricane, believe it or not. I'm not too clued up on bombs exactly, but that is quite a small bomb, and Hurricanes can actually deliver bombs, no problem. So yeah, Mosquito as well could feature in its bomb bay. Yeah, it's quite nice. There's the back there. Another great figure here. Again, look at those bullets on that belt. You're highly visible. I mean, there's other Airfix figures. You wouldn't get that amount of detail coming through. That looks really good. Bit flashy on his hand. It does look like for a minute he's holding something he isn't. There's just a little nodule of flash on there, but the face is great. I really hope this looks good when I recheck it, but the face is really good. Flying cap, his hand, it's a good figure. Yeah, so quite enjoying this review. There you go, there's all his bullets there, highly visible. Great figure. He's come through very, very well. And like I say, I do apologize, because on this I am going to be two figures short to show you. Which is the WAF and the other officer that there was in the original. Like I say, my eBay buyer let me down, so I was two figures short. So now this guy, I'm not entirely sure what he's doing, whether or not he's going for a wheel and maybe just unscrewing the wheel. I don't think he's filling anything up because he's a bit low in regards to fuel. So I'm not too sure. Anyone with any ideas, let me know, just put it in the comments. But again, he's a nice figure and pretty standard on the back. So here's our guys carrying the rocket. They do fit quite well. I haven't fully attached it there just because I'm being lazy, but it does actually fit remarkably snugly in there. It is a different color. That's nothing to do with anything unusual. That's because when I ordered this on eBay, he gave me about three extra sprues, and even the three extra sprues had the missing WAF, Women's Auxiliary Air Force officer, and also the standard officer that was on the sprue. So even with the extra three sprues, I still didn't get the extras. However, I got these sort of extras, so I can't complain too much. Just for the purpose of the review, I'm a bit annoyed. So again, great. That's the reason why I date this a little bit later, due to the fact that we've got rockets in this set, but it really doesn't matter. You know, you can just dispense with the rockets and have it early war Battle of Britain, no problem. The pilots look great, so, you know, absolutely no issue there. So here's our two chaps with the accumulator trolley, and this thing starts up aircraft engines. So this is what this item is. The actual trolley does have a peg at the top of the handlebar, but there's no place for it to go in the back of the shoulder, the guy pulling. So you could probably cut that out from the handle to fit a bit more snugly, to be honest. It has got grips to take the handle, so it probably does work fairly well. And the other guy, he's just pushing it along. So again, that's a really good thing to have for your aircraft dioramas or whatever. Make sure you've got this. Just need a little bit of tartan up. It's quite basic, but you're not talking much. Snaps together quite well. It's a two-part thing, and it goes together very nicely. These are the two chaps that do push it. So there's a little look at them. I'm back in the original colours here. And yeah, not too bad. A little bit flashy on the guy pushing. So, that was my review of Airfix's RAF Personnel 172 scale model figures. And I have to say, I think this kit still just about does it. It's aging well. It's not too bad. There's a few issues with a couple of mold lines in the figures and, you know, a little bit flashy here and there. This is the older original kit that I've reviewed. I mean, there's one that precedes this box art. I don't know how good the quality of the mold was on there, and whether or not the newer red box mold is any improvement on that, whether or not they're using better plastic or whatever, I don't know. But these ones weren't too bad. A couple issues with the mold lines here and there on the odd figure, but all in all, up to its usual high standard at the time. So yeah, it still holds up to this day, I think, and I don't think really there's much else about, so I could be wrong on that, but I don't think I am. So, you know, going up in scales, there's always something around, but for 172, I think this one still remains the better of the kits out there for that. So if you want an RAF support group personnel, this was probably the one. So, thank you for watching. I do apologize for the two missing figures, and we'll see you soon. Thank you.